No, I didn't hear it.
I didn't say it.
What'd you say to my face?
Someone upstairs said, I don't know who it was, but they were complaining that their pussy hurts.
What a guy. Buddy's got jokes, eh? We're gonna hit some fresh tracks today. Cooking some fresh bacon and some eggs.
Yo, can I ride with y'all? Alright, got the first run out of the way. We're about to go down Spitfire, and then we're gonna go shack hunting today, so
be prepared.
Captain's log. We are shack hunting right now. And then right there. It's deep. We're trugging through this. I think I found some tracks, so we're gonna follow the tracks and see if that leads it. I came here. I'm not gonna disclose the area because if Breckenridge finds out where this is, they blow them up. So you have to find them on your own if you're here. But my friends and I came down here. Oh man, high altitude hiking is not fun. But we came down there last time, so we're gonna check over that hill right there. It's supposed to be 100 feet in to the right, down a steep drop. And it's supposed to be pretty obvious if we know if we're there, so we'll see if we find it. Expedition was a success. We found the underground shack. We're gonna go down and slide down a hill, man. We're gonna go slide down. It's right down there. We're gonna go slide down this little ramp right here and go in there. Chris, high five. Let's get it, buddy. Here's the shack. Going in. Wish me luck. Snow in the winds, hopefully that doesn't mess it up. All right, I'm going down.
Sorry. Chris was holding on to this.
Yeah.
Oh, put all your weight on that.
Is my backpack stuck on that?
All right. Shit. I shine the light in here. I don't know how they built this, dude. This is like built into the, it's like a little hobbit hole, dude. But yeah, this is insane, man. You coming down? All right, this is shack number two. We found this one earlier. Found this one way earlier in the season. This is Narnia, the shack of Narnia. So, 2 out of 13 found.
Now in my younger days, I used to sport a shag. When I dream of fairy tales, I think of me and Shelly. See, she's my type of hype and I can't stand when brothers tell me that I should quit chasing and look for something better. But the smile that she shows makes me a go-getter. I haven't gone as far as asking if I could get with her. I just play love by ear and hope she gets the picture. I'm shooting for her heart, got my finger on the trigger. She can be my broad and I can be high, and I can be high. All I can do is stay up. Back as kids we used to kiss when we played truth or dare. Now she's more sophisticated, highly educated, not at all overrated. I think I need a prayer to get in a book, and it looks rather dry. I guess a twinkle in her eye is just a twinkle in her eye. Although she's crazy stepping, I try and stop the stride, cause I won't have no more of this passing me by.
Time for me to voice my opinion, can't be pretending she didn't have me. Sprung like a chicken, chasing my tail like a doggy. She was kind of like a star, thinking I was like a fan. Damn, she looked good, downside she had a man. He was a Rudy dude, a Nick and Poo. She told me soon your little birdie's gonna fly the coop. She was a flake like corn, and I was born not to understand. By letting the past, I proved to be a better man.
There she goes again, the dopest Ethiopian. And now the world around me begins moving in slow motion whenever she happens to walk by. Why does the apple of my eye overlook and disregard my feelings no matter how much I try? Wait, no, I did not really pursue my little princess with persistence. And I was so low-key that she was unaware of my existence. From a distance I desired her.